हेलो माय डियर चिल्ड्रेन, आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू द वर्चुअल क्लासेस पावर्ड बाय जेट किड्स इंटरनेशनल स्कूल पुसद टू आर क्लास वन. यस, आवर सब्जेक्ट इज साइंस. टुडेज आवर टॉपिक इज लेसन नंबर वन, थिंग्स अराउंड अस, एंड सब टॉपिक इज रिविजन. So children, today I am going to take your revision of lesson number 1, Things Around Us. Actually, we have studied this lesson in our previous video in detail. Okay. So children, shall we start? Okay. So let us see which are the points are there that we have to cover. So see children, in this lesson we have to learn about living things. What is mean by living things? Then we have to learn about non-living things. What is mean by non-living things? And next one, natural and man-made things. Okay. So children, if you having your textbook, open page number 7. Now look at the picture given below. What are the different things that you can see in this picture? And fill in the missing letters to name these things. I know you have did this activity. Okay. And some of you have sent your PH on my WhatsApp also. So children, so we know it very well. So children, here I am going to explain again about this picture. Okay. So we can see in this picture there are living things and non-living things are also. Okay. The things around us can be living or non-living. As we can see in this picture, aeroplane, bird, car, dog, cat, scooter, children, slide, trees, building, girl. Okay. So, in that we can see some things are living, that they are moving from here and there. And some are non-living thing. Yes, some are non-living thing. So, children, living things are different from non-living things. Living things are different from non-living things. So let us see how, what is the difference in that we will see. Okay. So see this picture children. Now we are looking about living things. We are looking about living things. So what is mean by living thing children? Plants, animals and humans are living things. Given below are the characteristics of living things. So children, now we are looking about living things. So plants, animals and humans are living things. So here as you can see in your textbook on page number 8, there are some characteristics with pictures. Okay. So see children, number 1, living things breathe. Like see this picture, child breathing. Yes, we inhale, exhale with our nose. Okay, so we can breathe. So living things breathe. Second one, living things move. Like in this picture, second picture, boy playing with a ball. Yes, this boy playing with ball. Now he is moving from one place to another. So living things can move, living things can breathe. Yes. So children, these are the characteristics now we are looking. So see the next characteristic. It means how to identify. So number 3, living things eat. Like in this picture, we can see the picture of cow. Cow eating grass. Okay. The living things can eat. Living thing eat. Okay. So, in this picture, cow eating grass. Number 4, living thing grow. Living things grow. Okay. So, examples are also here. Like first example, lamb. Now, lamb is a, as we can see, small lamb. Now, it grows into sheep. Grows into sheep. Then, next one, baby boy. Next one, we can see baby boy. So, grows up, grows into man. Okay. So, children, In this way, living things grow. Living things grow. So children, getting? Living things breathe, living things move, living things eat, living things grow like lamb, like baby boy. Next one, number 5, living things produce young ones. Like we can see the picture of hen, okay? Hen with chicks. Hen with chicks. So children, living things produce young ones. Next one, number 6, living things feel happiness and pain. Like we can see in this picture, this boy, yes, he is crying. Why he is crying? Because he is wounded, okay? And that is why he is crying, okay? So it means living things can feel. They can become happy, can become pain, okay? So this boy, he hurt. That's why he is crying. So children, in this way, we have seen the characteristics of living things. So in this way, we can identify which are the living things. Now move to next. Now, non-living things. So children, now we are looking non-living things. So see with picture, non-living things like a book, pencil, football and eraser do not breathe, move on their own, eat, grow, feel and produce young ones. Like see this picture, children, these all like book, pencil, football, eraser, yes, all these are non-living things, okay, because they can't move, they can't breathe, they can't eat, grow, feel and produce young ones. That is why these all things are non-living things. Okay. So children, in this way we have seen living things and non-living things. For moving football, yes, with our help it can move. Okay. So children, we have seen about non-living things. Hope you are getting children. Now move to next. Uses of non-living things. As we have seen non-living things. Now what are their uses children? We will see. So non-living things are used by living things in many ways. Okay. Like we use book, we use pencil, football, eraser. Yes. So children, we use it. We use this non-living thing. So number 1 children, water is used for drinking, bathing, washing, clothes, cooking, etc. So children, water is a non-living thing. We know, okay. But we people use it for drinking, for bathing, okay. Then washing, then washing clothes, okay. Then cooking, okay. So in this way we use it. Second, rocks are used for building houses. So rocks are used for building houses. Okay, rock is non-living thing. We use it to make, to build our houses. Okay. Number 3, plastic, iron and steel are used to make things like cars, spoons and utensils. Then we use plastic. Plastic is also non-living. Iron is also non-living. Steel is also non-living. We use it for what reason, children? To make a cars, spoons and utensils. So children, in this way, we use non-living things to our work. For our convenience, we use it. Okay. So, non-living things are also important for us. Getting children? So, in this way, we have seen about the uses of non-living things. Now, see natural and man-made things. Now, children, what is mean by natural thing and man-made things? So, see, Try to read with me. Things that are found in nature are called natural things. Natural things can be living or non-living. So children, the things that we found in nature are called natural things. Okay. So natural things can be living or non-living also. Okay. Natural thing, the things in nature we can found, it's called natural thing. And it may be, it can be living or non-living. Like examples of natural living things are plants and animals. Okay. Plants and animals are natural living things. Plants and animals are natural living things. Now we will see the example of natural non-living things. So see in this picture also, rocks, river, air and soil. These are natural non-living things we can see in our nature. Okay. And these are non-living. It can't breathe, move. Okay. It can't produce young ones. It can't grow. So these are natural non-living things. Getting? Things that are made by human beings are known as man-made things. Examples are hat, book and cycle. Children, the things that are made by human beings, so that things are known as man-made things. For example, hat, it is also a man-made thing. Book, man-made thing. Cycle, man-made thing. Okay. Man-made things are used by humans to make their work easy and simple. All man-made things are non-living things. So children, now we are looking about man-made things. What is mean by man-made things? It means man-made thing, it means the things that are made by human, made by people. Okay, that is why it is known as man-made. Okay, so like we have seen bottle, we have seen in detail also in our previous video, like bottle, benches, then buildings, all these are man-made thing. Okay, so children, man-made things are used by humans to make their work easy and simple. Okay, so all these man-made things are used by we people. For what reason? To make our work simple and easy. Okay, like we will take an example of fan. When we feel hot, what we do? So we switch on the fan. Okay, so we switch on the fan. So that is why we feel nice, we feel cool. Okay, so children, these all things made by man. That is why it's called man-made things. All man-made things are non-living things. All the things which is made by man, which is made by people or human, all these are non-living things. Like hat, we can see in front of you, examples are there, like hat, like cycle. Yes, these are man-made, but these are non-living. Getting? So children, in this way, we have seen this lesson. So read it properly, children, and go through it. And hope you got it very well. Now, what is your PH? You have to make 1 or 2 minutes short video, and you have to post it on my WhatsApp. So children, go through it. Take care. And children, till then, thank you.